So let's continue from the previous video. Let's resize the browser to a smaller screen. Now you notice the left sidebar display before the content column, right? Now not everyone will prefer to present in this way. Some of you may prefer to show the main content column on the top above all the sidebars, something like this. Let's inspect element. Okay. See that? So we want to show the main content column before the sidebar. Now the sidebar is at the bottom. Now reordering these two columns' position are not a problem. The problem is on the larger screens. Let's close this. You'll find this left sidebar has gone to the right. If the right sidebar exists, you'll be overlaid. So how do we handle this? Now if you know Bootstrap well, you know there's a way you can do it with pull and push columns to reorder the columns. This is something more advanced really, which I don't plan initially to share this. But I realized in a real world situation, it's quite a common request from the clients to ask for moving all the sidebars below the main content on the mobile screen. So I think it's important for you to know that too. Now if you are interested, we'll proceed. Let's inspect the right sidebar again. Now this time we have to add the pull and push column classes to the left sidebar and the main content column. If you know Bootstrap well, you know what I mean, alright? Now for this main column, right, make it smaller. I'll add a class to push three columns to the right, alright? That should be call md push dash 3. Yep, it moves three columns to the right. Now for this sidebar, I will pull nine columns from the left. It's actually a number of columns of this main content column. So kind of reverse. Now let's add that. Column md medium pull 9. See that? It's back to where it was. So the positions remain the same. Now let's resize the screen to a smaller screen. Good, it works. Close this. Great, it works perfectly. So two things to do here. One is to shift the left sidebar region down below the main content region. Next is to add pull and push columns classes to the sidebars and main content column. Since the CSS classes on sidebars may be different depends on the number of sidebar present, we need to create two new variables, one for the left sidebar and another for the right sidebar. Now let's do it one by one. First we open our text editor, go to subtheme folder, templates, let's open page.tbl.php. Scroll down. Now we'll cut the whole left sidebar region here. Scroll down. And paste it right below the main content section. Let's save it. Back to our site. Let's refresh the browser. So as we expected, the sidebar has moved to the right because we haven't applied the pull and push columns classes yet. Let's inspect element and check the smaller screen. Yes, at least this is working. Yep, the sidebar has moved down. Let's apply the push and pull this time. Back to our editor. Open the template.php this time. Scroll down. Let's look for template.php. Open it. Now we're going to make some changes here on the code. I will replace all this code with a new code. I'll paste the new code here and explain further. Well, it's a bit of code, but not difficult to understand. No worry, the code is provided with a tutorial, because I believe you mess up some way if I were to ask you to code it yourself, especially so many single and double quotes around, right? So basically, we created two new variables for the first sidebar and the second sidebar. And the conditional statements are more or less the same. So let's explain a little. It says here, if the left sidebar not empty and the right sidebar not empty, which is sidebar second, this means both sidebars present, then the content column class will be this, medium 6 and push 3, right? So the sidebar first will be this classes, right? The second sidebar will be this. If there's only left sidebar, which is the sidebar first exists, then your content column class will be this, right? And then your first sidebar will be this. We will add the push class to the main content column and a pull class to the left sidebar, as I showed you earlier. And if only right sidebar exists, then it's much simpler. Basically, the main content column is only showing this for 9 column, and the right sidebar is showing this 3 columns. So they're both together 12 columns. If none of the sidebars exist, then of course it will show the original 12 columns, full columns. Alright? Now we need to put these variables, first sidebar class and the second sidebar class, back to our page template for the two sidebars. So let's save this page first. Save it. Back to our page template. That is page.tpl.php. Alright, open this. Scroll up a bit. Let's copy this variable from the main content area. Copy it. Scroll down. Remove this class as it's going to be output by our code and paste the code here. So we paste it next and close to the assign tag just like your main content. Take note there's no space in between, alright? We'll try to follow the same way of coding as much as possible. Surely you can do it in other ways you like as long as you understand the logic on how it works. It's flexible. Now, let's rename this variable to our newly created sidebar variable. Let's go. First, sidebar class. Alright? So make sure the class name is correct. Now we'll copy from this and replace this for right sidebar. Now this time we'll change this first to second. So it should be second sidebar class. Double check again and make sure all correct and save the template. Back to our Drupal site. Let's flush the cache. You can see a left sidebar move back to its own original position. Resize the browser. That's great. So you can see the left sidebar has moved down. Let's inspect element and see. Now the new classes are added to main content. That is push 3 columns. And for the sidebar, it's added pull 9 columns from the left. So whenever you close this inspect element, in the larger screen, the left sidebar will move back to its own original position without being affected. Alright? Now let's try to add a block to the right region to test it out. Okay? So let's go to structure, blocks, scroll down, look for the secondary region. Okay, here. Let's move the search block from primary region to the secondary region. We'll test it out. Okay, scroll down, save it. go to the front page, check it out. Great, it's not affected, it display well. Resize the browser and see. Now you can see the two sidebars move down to the bottom. That's exactly of what we want. Now, if yours not working, do double check the quotes carefully. Check the empty space, variables name, syntax and the quotes. Of course, remember the fast cache as well. Now, a little tough to you in this tutorial, but I believe it's very useful skill for you, right? Congrats. Let's proceed to the next. Okay, wait. Remember to put this search block back to the right sidebar. Okay, see you next.